We're learning more about a SWAT standoff that ended peacefully in Taylorsville last night. Unified Police arrested 43-year-old Ben Williams after they say he attacked his parents and fired several gunshots at officers. Fox 13's John Franke has a deeper look into the SWAT team response.
This neighborhood is quiet now, but only after some very tense hours Saturday evening into Saturday night. Ending this standoff took some patience from Unified Police.
A probable cause statement gives insight into the dangerous situation UPD encountered when officers first arrived at the home where Ben Williams is accused of barricading himself inside. They allege he shot at different UPD officers and targeted the armored SWAT vehicle.
If he's going to fire at police officers, what else is he going to do?
Chris Bertram is a retired deputy chief with Unified Police. He is not surprised the officers at the scene showed restraint.
If they feel they're safe, there's no need to return fire at that point. They can put themselves in tactically advantaged positions. They can negotiate with the person, but still have that safety element of that specialized equipment.
In fact, the charging document indicates that despite Williams firing at the armored car, its bulletproof glass prevented the SWAT members from getting hit by the array of bullets or even from dying. Bertram believes that level of protection and preparedness gave officers time to de-escalate the situation.
But in a lot of circumstances, if you just take your time, things will work themselves out. People are in emotionally high states. We know that if, as time goes on, those estates may, you know, again, diminish. They may start to think more rationally.
Investigators say Williams later admitted to shooting at the police because he, quote, was not having it, end quote. He was booked in the Salt Lake County Jail early Sunday morning.
This is a great outcome. But I want to also be realistic that not all of them can end like this. But we would hope that the majority do.
And that suspect, Ben Williams, faces several felony charges, including assault against a police officer. In Taylorsville, John Franke, Fox 13 News, Utah.
Fox 13 reporter Diego Romo spoke with one of Williams' family members who say they are just devastated by Saturday's events. He joins us live now in studio with more details tonight. Diego.
One of Williams' relatives says they have never known him to be a violent person and added that he has struggled with substance abuse and mental health issues in the last few years. A probable cause affidavit from 2018 details a similar incident to the domestic dispute that led up to Saturday's standoff. The document states that Williams threw his aunt on the bed and choked her after she refused to take him to a nearby store to buy spray paint, which he was using to huff. The relative I spoke with asked that we conceal her identity for privacy.
It's impacted our family a lot. I mean, we don't usually, you know, we see stuff like this on the news, but you would never think it would happen to your own family. So we're all kind of just distraught by the whole situation.
Now, Williams was booked on three second-degree felonies resulting from the domestic violence incident in 2018. His relative says Williams' parents are home and recovering from the injuries they sustained Saturday. Live in the Fox 13 studios, Diego Romo.
Diego, thank you. If you've been a victim of domestic violence, there are resources out there for you. The Utah Domestic Violence Coalition has a 24-hour crisis line. You can learn more on our website, fox13now.com.